so if you're not really into that, I'm sorry, but this is more of like my midweek filler video, and I had no idea what I was going to post today or tomorrow, but I figured since it's relatively new news, I'm very, 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 very excited to be announcing that to you guys. So let's see some of the news here. Okay, so the NBA's target schedule for this next coming year and the next season, the start of the next season so far. Training camp starts July 9th to the 11th. Then the resumed 2019-2020 NBA season comes back July 31st through October 2nd. Season, the postseason NBA Finals is going to be from July 31st all the way to about October 12th. Then we have the NBA Draft Lottery, which is August 25th, so a pretty big jump from, you know, July to, you know, end of July to end of August to wait for the lottery. And then the lottery is going on while the teams are playing in the playoffs, which is pretty interesting. And then we have the NBA Draft is October 15th. Which is super cool. I was so excited for the NBA draft, but they postponed all of it, which kind of makes sense because I wanted to see the draft lottery at least, but again, the season never ended, so that part kind of sucked. But the NBA draft is October 15th. Free agency starts on October 18th, which means teams can officially sign with other teams on October 18th, so that's pretty exciting. And then the 2020-2021 season's training camp starts November 10th, and then the official start of the NBA season for 2020-2021 is December 1st. A lot of people didn't really like that because they would rather have it on like Christmas Day, because a lot of people think, oh, when you think Christmas, they think of opening presents, spending time with family, and then watching NBA basketball. That's at least what I do with my family, is watch NBA basketball while we open our presents. While we sit around and talk, eat, yada yada yada, duty on more during Christmas than actual Christmas movies. So if that's the same for you guys, let me know down in the comments. So that's pretty exciting. NBA basketball is going to return. I'm super excited about that. So I know what you're thinking. ASM Baller, who are the teams that are invited to the new season? I guess the restart of the season. Now it's going to be the regular 1-8 seeds for the NBA playoffs. So what it goes like, what, Lakers, Clippers, Nuggets, I think. I don't know. It goes somewhere like that. Yada yada yada. And then through the East as well, the 1-8 seeds. And then for the West, you had to be within 8 games of the 8th spot to qualify to be back into the regular season. Are Portland, who's at 9th, then you have the Pelicans, then you have the Spurs, then you have the Kings. Those teams are all, 4 of those teams are invited to the restart of the season, which is super exciting. And the Suns as well. The Suns are also, I think, in it as well. And then for the East, I think it's just the Wizards. I think the Wizards are invited back because they're in the 9th spot right now. So that's also pretty exciting, but who knows if they can make it. I don't know if John Wall plays again, like, who really knows, but so that's really exciting. It's also very interesting because when they return to the, you know, regular season, second easiest strength of schedule in the NBA at the end of, you know, the regular season. They had the second easiest. Memphis had the hardest, I think. They had at least the top three hardest strength of schedule left. So Portland was probably going to catch them. I think Portland was on a pretty decent win streak. Well, not like winning games, but they were winning a lot more games than they were at the beginning of the season because they started finally clicking because they finally had somewhat of a set rotation now that they had their trades done and the injuries are over, yada, yada, yada. They finally started, you know, gaining some traction. Memphis was on a couple game losing streak. They were kind of losing themselves, but not in like a bad way. No offense to any Memphis fans, but yeah. So that's one of the reasons why, because now Portland has to play 8 games against the toughest teams in the NBA, and it's gonna be very tough. I'm very eager to see if the NBA, when they make up these schedules, take into account that Portland had the second easiest strength schedule at the end of last season. Well, the end before the break of the season. I wonder if they're gonna take that into consideration and give them an easier schedule playing against teams like, no offense, again, these are the top 22 teams in the league, but the Wizards, the Suns, Sacramento, teams like that, the Spurs as well. I think the Spurs are in it as well. No offense to any of those teams. All those teams are great. All these teams are great. That's the thing. That's the thing why Portland doesn't really like this idea. So it's gonna be kind of interesting. And then, so in my opinion, I wished the season would have ended and Portland didn't make the playoffs because we would have a better draft pick. I've been telling Portland to tank this whole season, but they didn't. So maybe they will now, and I'll be happy about it. But so, and then at the end of the 8 game regular season, the 8th and 9th seed, I think, I don't think it's just for the West, but I think also for the East, if they're in a 3 games back standings. So say if like the New Orleans Pelicans make the 9th seed and they're like 2.5 games back of Memphis, they will play in a play-in tournament. Now if, you know, Portland, San Antonio, Spurs, yada yada yada, if they're all behind 3 games, I think Memphis just automatically makes it to the playoffs, which is a good idea. But if they do, same thing with the Wizards in the Eastern Conference. But I don't think they have any competition. I think they're really just competing with themselves and seeing how many games they can play and beat to see if they can breach the Orlando Magic. But if they do, I'm sorry, I keep getting sidetracked. If they do are in that range of games, they will play in a tournament. No, this isn't like a March Madness tournament, which the NBA just totally they teased us the whole time and they didn't give us it. So basically this play-in tournament is Memphis would play the 9th seed, whoever it is. Like I said before, let's say it's the Pelicans. Memphis would play the Pelicans in a game. If the Pelicans won and beat Memphis, they would play again, like the next day or something like that. And then if the Pelicans lose that game, Memphis goes on to the playoffs. But if the Pelicans win again, they move on to the playoffs, if that makes any sense. So basically, the 9th seed has to win 2 times in a row to make the playoffs. Memphis only has to win once. I hate that factor. That's super stupid. It's such an uphill climb for the 9th seed to make the playoffs. It's literally not even worth it. They're going to have blood, sweat, and tears. The players are probably going to get injured. And I don't think it's a very good or safe idea. I would rather have at least a single game tournament. You know, they could have had Memphis play who's ever the 11th seed, and then Portland play who's ever in the 10th seed, and then whoever wins those games go on to play each other. And then I think I'd rather have that idea, but it's just, I don't know what the NBA's doing. It gives Memphis a drastic advantage. They could literally rest all of their starters the first game, and then whoever's the 9th seed could beat them, and then in the next day, I think it was Woj or someone say, they play the next day, and then Memphis is all ready to go, and they're going to get swamped. They're going to swap the 9th seed. So, I don't know. I don't think it's very fair, but I'm very excited to see what happens. You know, if Memphis wins and makes it to the playoffs, awesome. I'd love to see Ja Morant, you know, and, you know, Jaren Jackson. I think he's coming back. Who knows? But if they go up against the Lakers, that's super cool. If not, it gives the Lakers an easier way and LeBron an easier way to the championship, which, you know, I love LeBron. I love the Lakers, so I'm definitely not opposed to that at all. Or, you know, if it is the Blazers, it's going to be a great first-round matchup. If it's Zion, it's Zion versus LeBron. If it's the Spurs, you know, it's a great Popovich finally, you know, keeping the streak alive and making the playoffs. all those times. I mean, the Kings could make it. The Suns could make it. Like, who knows? You can see playoff Devin Booker finally. I don't know. It's kind of exciting. But I also heard rumored that there's going to be home team advantages when playing in the schedules. So I think the home teams get some sort of advantage if you play a home, if you're the home team, because they're all going to be based in Disney World. They have their own little, you know, basketball center there and stuff like that. So I'm very excited to see how that all works out. I'm also really excited to see how the games are going to get played out on TV. Are they going to play music over the games? Are they going to have music and commentary? Are they going to just let the players play and you're just going to hear everything the players say? Which is terrifying to think about, because you know trash talking and yada 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 is going to be going on, especially in the playoffs and the finals. Like, it's going to be crazy. Let's see here. What else did I want to do more about? I think I liked some things that I wanted to talk about. Apparently the lottery changes are also a thing. So it says here the 14 NBA lottery teams would be the 8 teams that did not participate in the restart, and the 6 teams that participate in the restart but do not qualify for the playoffs. So those are going to be the draft lottery odds, which is the usual. If you don't make the playoffs or in the draft lottery, if you didn't come back to the 22 selected teams, you're automatically in the draft lottery, which makes sense. These teams would be seeded in the lottery and assigned odds based on their records through the games of March 11th. The 16 playoff teams would draft in inverse order of their combined records across regular season games and seeding games. So the draft lottery is also going to be very different, I think, than what we're used to, which is, again, something very confusing. I don't know why they're doing this, but I think that's also why Portland sort of voted against it. But hey, it's not that bad. Definitely could be a lot worse. Yeah. Let's see here. There was an article written by one of the Blazers. What do I want to say? Press people. Let's see here. I think I already explained all this, like the play-in and things like that. I'm very excited to see, you know, players come back for a lot of different teams. Like I said before, John Wall has said he's 100%, so maybe he comes back and makes a little playoff push with the Wizards. I highly doubt it. Like, poor Jaw. Jaren Jackson Jr., I think, was hurt before the break, and I think he might come back. That'd be kind of cool. LeBron's rested. Kawhi's rested. No excuses for Kawhi. Kawhi better play all 8 of those games. No more excuses from anyone. Every single one of the players in the NBA should be playing all 8 of those games. I don't want to hear, oh, I'm resting, yada, yada, yada. No, Kawhi better be playing all 8 of those games. Same thing with LeBron. I want to see it happen. Then obviously, the healthy Yusuf Nurkic was supposed to come back. Like, he was supposed to play his first game of the season, like, a day or two before the season got canceled, postponed, which is crazy. So he's going to be back. We're going to have Yusuf and Hassan Whiteside holding it down. Zach Collins is, like, a game-time decision. They're not really sure about him yet, which is pretty interesting. I don't think Rodney Hood is going to play, which sucks because he's our starting small forward, but at least we have Melo, and I'm just hoping, you know, all the players have been safe and smart. You've seen a lot of players protesting, which I hope they are, you know, keeping safe, wearing masks, things like that, because, I mean, if one of these players gets sick, I'll just say sick, then it's going to be very interesting to see what the NBA does to what happens to these players. So yeah, guys, I'm really not too sure what else I really wanted to talk about besides that. Like I said, I'm very excited, and I'm very, 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 very anxious to see, you know, these teams and how they're going to pull it off and what it's going to look like, and, you know, how this is going to affect the league and sports in general for the next coming months. It's crazy. The world is very crazy right now, so I really hope I can be here to help you out and feeling some sort of normality to the world. Because I know for me it's very different, and it's different in a good way for different reasons, and it's different in a bad way for different reasons. So I hope you're just doing well, keeping safe.
Soon, right, guys?